్రహ్మాదిభ్యో బ్రహ్మ విద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశ ఋషభ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యర్వోపప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన ఘన ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి. ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైక పాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుఖే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బిస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పెరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మి కటాక్షంస్ టు యూ అండ్ ఎంటైర్ యువర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్. Let us begin Bhagavad Gita, verse number 16 of 6th chapter. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha, Natyashnatastu Yogosti, Nachaikantamanashnatah, Nachatiswapnashilasya, Jagrato Naivacharjuna. Bhagavan Krishna again brings Bahiranga Sadhanani. Because they were in the battlefield, not having any plan how to set an academic style of teaching. Just whatever came in his mind, he spoke and he unfolded the truth of the method of meditation. In the last words, he used the word Shantim Nirvana Paramam. We have to take like Nirvana Paramam Shantim Mat Samstham Adhigachati. Shanti means a peace of the mind. And also we get the worldly peace in our mind. When we experience the peace, that peace you can understand when we depend on something. When you listen to a music, you become peace, you are relaxed. Then, when you also in the sleep, you experience the peace. Then again, in so many other ways, some people, you know, when they read book, they are finding the peace. When they do something, when they indulge with something, or when they engage with something, for the time being, they experience the peace of the mind, which is a fake peace. You might be wondering, oh my God, Swamiji, how can you say, when lovable person is nearby, and also we feel the peace of the experience? No, my dear, that too fake peace. We have to accept the truth and fact. Now, what kind of peace Bhagavan Krishna says? That peace which cannot be distracted by any other source of the world. Is there that kind of the peace? We have not informed and not experienced from the birth till the last second. Therefore, Krishna just he says, this Shanti, Paramam Shantim, Supreme Peace, that peace never go once you attain it. Once you realize it, even that peace doesn't depend on physical, psychological system. We need not to depend on outside object. Even you need not to depend on your system, because peace is nothing but our nature. That is the proper understanding Bhagavan Krishna brings here. After saying the destination and prayojana benefit, now again he brings very important topic for a human being. Now he says, a yogi who should be endowed with moderation. In moderation, what, where, in what kind of things? Moderation in sleep, eating, and work. When he works, he has to maintain the moderation. When he eats, he has to be endowed with moderation. When he sleeps, that also with moderation. Now this eating habit is a big challenge for a human being. I have seen many people, they call it binge eating. Binge eating means overeating. This overeating is a kind of habits. So which is, we can say, we can find with so many varieties of people, and large amount of people are suffering by this overeating. Though they want to stop that binge eating, they are not able to. First of all, the cause of binge eating is not because you taste the food, you become addicted to that. A yogi who is not addicted for anything, he is very awareful soul, he could limit everything. That limitation what we want to understand about. Now what the yogi's mind and what is the normal people's mind? We should know the difference. How can we should be aware about these things? When a child grows, a child, when according to his age, you know, year by year, day by day, every day we need to be satisfied our mind. There are so many other needs, you know, physical needs are there, emotional needs are there, social needs are there. When a child is denied for something, at that time, child is endowed with some kind of dissatisfaction. In order to overcome that dissatisfaction, it begins to eat a lot. Because unknowingly our psychological system, you know, it wants to balance, to be endowed with proper existence. I mean, so mind needs certain satisfaction. If it is not able to get in one portion, it wants to get in other portions. Therefore, they become uncontrolled when they get addicted with something. People started eating over means something wrong with their relationship, something wrong with their decision making, something was denied in the young age. In order to compensate it, the habit added. The incident from which they have begun this habit might have been forgotten, but the habit continues. So the habit becomes more stronger because of the habits. Keep going. Now brain will stick with the habits. Then what? Brain will trigger again and again. They will become addicted to that. Overeating, smoking, drinking, over drinking, all these things because of what? Not having or providing healthy environment for the mind to grow properly. In Vedantic view, we can say that the child gets the environment according to the karma phala. That is the great escapism. Our parents have the duty to provide proper environment. Proper growth of the child must be observed that by the parents. The parents, they do have the duty to observe all those things. Now, overeating is not a disease, it's because of some lacking inside. We have to find that cause from when it has begun. Now, Bhagavan Krishna says, a yogi who is moderate with eating, he knows what is the limit, how to eat, when to eat, what to eat, and how much to eat. Now, what is the measurement for me? Because human being, we have different system. Every body differs one each other. Now, how can be said for a person? So, if a person has one roti, one chapati, the another person needs two chapati. Therefore, you have to set the limitation. How can I feel the limitation? How can I come to know this is what the limitation of mine? The simple way, when you start eating, you could feel that there is a burp comes first time. You have to sit on the floor always when you have food. Breakfast or lunch or dinner doesn't matter. And also in between breakfast, lunch, dinner, we should not have anything. No snacks, no kurmuri, just throw it. And don't accept, you know, every once in a 2 hours we should have something. No, you can have lots of water. That water also should be consumed as, you know, sipping like a tea. We should not drink, you know, like open the tap, it goes, you know, directly to the stomach. No, it has to be sipped. That is the healthy habits. Breakfast, lunch, dinner, or you can have 2 times in a day your food. The first rule is stick with your hunger. Daily experience your hunger. You cannot get from the market. Can you ask, you know, I need 1 kg of hunger? No. You have to find, you have to wait to see, to feel, to experience your hunger. Once you get the hunger, enjoy the hunger at least for 5 or 10 minutes, then you can begin to eat. But when you eat, make peaceful of restless state. Then when you put into the mouth, you chew well and taste them, concentrate on the food, be endowed with this taste. Then you chew well and take more time for that, then swallow it. Make a liquid and swallow it. You cannot eat too much. When you swallow the food, you can eat too much. Now you be patient and eat slowly. Don't talk to anybody. Don't watch anybody. Just simply eat. In order to overcome overeating, eat properly. That is the best techniques. When you eat like that, after certain time, burp will come. That is the first indication you have to stop. And you should not drink in between while eating lunch or breakfast or dinner. The drink, any liquid can be taken after half an hour or till the before half an hour. This is the habit of eating. When you eat, only eat. And before eating, before putting anything in your mouth, you confirm you are endowed with hunger. If there is no hunger, you don't accept even Deva Mrita is provided to you. Just deny it. That is the healthy life. The yogi is very careful. He won't consider the stomach as the basket. Basket can be filled with materials, but the stomach, it should not be. There should be space. There should be the space in order to get the food digested. The Jatharagni must be maintained. Jatharagni is known as a fire for the digestion. That has to be taken care of. You should not lose the Jatharagni. And all the problems begins from the stomach, even headache or any aching, any pain, any disease comes in your body, even tumors, cancers, or because of what? Indigested food. That indigested food becomes poisonated. They produce the toxins. Body, when it sets with too much toxicity, those conditions are called a disease, cause of the disease. You don't allow it. Now you focus on eating first. The eating habits has to be normalized, regularized. And also, don't go with the timing which is followed outside. 8 o'clock breakfast or 9 o'clock breakfast, 2 o'clock lunch, and again 8 o'clock dinner. No. You have to see your body. Sometimes when you eat in the morning, it may not be digested because we eat all colorful, colored or artificial modified food. It may not be digested. Even this old Western food, I don't want to name them. You may get, you know, all this East made food are not suitable for us. We are the Indians, we are Bharatvasis, and we should have our food. And the foreigners, they have their own food for them, that is okay. If they follow our food, they will be also healthy. Because we alone have a proper systematic of food to be given to the human being. No non-veg. So a vegetarian can maintain a proper food. Now when you eat, you should eat that which is suits for you. Eat, you have to read your digestion. If you are not aware about your digestion, you are not taught how to live, how to eat. Life is not to eat. Eating is for the life. Eat to live, not live to eat. That is the formula one should have. When you eat limited food, and that too suitable food, avoid all junk food, all this fast food, they are not suitable for you. Even in the normal life, you should maintain these rules and regulations. But when you are becoming a meditator, you should consider your body should not be overloaded by food. The body should have all panchabhuta. If body is getting more food, the body becomes heavier. That heaviness, when you feel the heaviness, you have to observe upavasa. Therefore, here he says, the sadhaka to be madhyavarti, having moderation in food and sleep. Not only that, so what is proper eating also, and what is overeating, and what is less eating, all these three kinds of conditions must be aware and careful by a sadhaka. He should be careful with less eating, overeating, moderate eating. He should know the variation so that he could follow it. Sometimes, you know, because of the social, because humans are social animals, if people are feeling loneliness, they eat too much. This eating habit must be corrected first. Automatically other habit will become perfect. And sleeping. The sleeping also, body needs sleep. I heard one sports person, so who got World Cup 3-4 times in 10 years, he used to sleep for 12 hours. Because physically, when he is very active, he needs that all those tissues to be rejuvenated. But we should not follow that same. We have to see how we work, what kind of physical or mental work we have. According to that, you should have the sleep. Less sleep or oversleep will collapse the body. Therefore, the sleep, after the sleep, you should have the freshness. Otherwise, something goes wrong. Either less sleep or oversleep. Before going to the bed, always I prefer go to the bed before 10 o'clock or before at least 11 o'clock. Before going to the bed, 1 hour before that, you have to stop seeing mobiles, watching television, and you just stop. That is the healthy habit. When you become okay with or you adapt this habit, your health will increase automatically, because sleep is very important. This meditator should have the proper sleep. It is not like that sleep. Some people, you know, they say, I don't sleep. My meditation itself is the sleep. In the meditation, I will be rejuvenated more than the sleep. It's not like that. A meditator should have the proper sleep. In the beginning itself, I told, in the meditation, when you are learning from somewhere or anybody, you have to observe, you should be very careful with your sleep. If you are getting disturbed sleep, something goes wrong, that path is wrong. You have to be aware about it. And when you work, that too, you know, sometimes we work, we become too much tired because of rajasic nature. All these things he will talk himself. When you select the food, that food should contain the sattvika nature, otherwise don't eat them. Don't eat, just deny it. And the taking too much coffee, tea is not our habits. Live with your energy, not artificial energy. And many people I have seen always going with a glucose bottle or pack. No, that glucose you can take as much as possible. You should not hang over them to live your life. That's what I say. Be careful. A meditator should be very careful during the sleep, with the sleep, with the working, with eating habits. Because so when he becomes a moderate person, a person who is endowed with moderation, he can succeed in spirituality. Then the next words, yukta hara viharasya yukta cheshtasya karmasu yukta svapnavabodhasya yogo bhavati dukkha. The one more big important thing Bhagavan Krishna says, be careful with your entertaining attitude. We want to be entertained, isn't it? Every day we wanted to be entertained. In those days, in order to get entertainment, we have to go to some theater or some kind of academy where dance programs or drama or play or cinema, whatever, in order to see, we have to reach. Now it is in our hand itself. As the mobile, don't allow too much your mind to engage with entertainment, because it is losing a lot of energy. Even a simple ad, when it comes, it makes lots of impact, you know, negative or positive, that's another matter. First, your brain and your mind should work a lot. That too, within 40 seconds, an ad will show a complete life of a person. From the young age to old age, he grows fast within 40 seconds. Then what? Your mind has to work according to that fast. Whether you are watching or not, your senses are aware and observing those things. The mind has got a tremendous power. It observes everything, whether you sleep or not. Therefore, when you sleep, you need to have a proper sleep. Proper sleep means you need to have at least complete darkness. And don't sleep when TV is on or some radio is on, some FM we call it, you know. Some people I have seen, they listen, they have FM, they keep on going that. So this listening to them is not the problem. Limit them. When you sleep, you remove all the noisy things, you remove all the things which spoils your eyes. Just sleep well. And when you want to entertain yourself, be very limited. Yukta ahara viharasya yukta cheshtasya karmasu. When you work also, you have to be endowed with moderation. Yukta svapnava bodhasya yogo bhavati dukkha. Don't make anything too much and don't make anything less. Be endowed with moderation, then those process, these disciplines definitely will help the sorrow of a yogi. He will be having energy in order to get progress in the spirituality. The next words,
yada viniyatam chittam atmanyeva vatishthate nispraha sarvakamebhyah yukta ityuchyate tada.
Bhagavan Krishna continues, yada viniyatam chittam atmanyeva vatishthate nispraha sarvakamebhyo yukta ityuchyate tada. He combines both. Now bahiranga sadhanas, and as it helps to get antaranga sadhana. First of all, bahiranga sadhana means what? Is it outer sadhana? No. Bahiranga sadhana means this bahiranga sadhanani, that which to be observed throughout the day. Okay. Antaranga sadhanani means immediate sadhanas, means conditions to be adapted. For selecting the place, deshaha, kalaha, time, asanam and posture, and not only that, the sthiti of your mind and the process which called it meditation, all this called antaranga sadhanani, immediate sadhanas to be observed. He says yada chittam viniyatam, when the mind is disciplined, the mind which can be established in Atma, the mind which is endowed with nispruhaha. Nispruhaha means a state which is not shaken by any desire, well controlled from all the desire, that person becomes yogi. Yuktaha and yogi, both are equal word. It denotes the same meaning. We will continue the next verse tomorrow in the next episode. Harihi Om.
Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.